wall. Now the last wall, that is lateral wall, please come on this side. The lateral wall will be consisting of tympanic membrane. So we have to draw tympanic membrane, very small and rough representation of tympanic membrane which will draw. Let us consider this as a tympanic membrane. So therefore this is what tympanic membrane is present, and I will write here as tympanic membrane. This is the lateral wall itself. Now what is present in front of tympanic membrane, I'll rub this. In front of tympanic membrane, supposing this is anterior, if this is anterior, we have this adytus to mastoid antrum. So posteriorly it will go towards this, where it will be known as mastoid antrum, posteriorly adytus, and then here there will be two divisions, one and two, anteriorly canal for tensor tympani and auditory tube. This is auditory tube and this will be canal for tensor tympani, and posteriorly this is the adytus to mastoid antrum. So anteriorly these two canals, and over here we will show that there will be presence of carotid canal. So in the carotid canal we draw this as internal carotid artery, carotid canal anterior, tympanic membrane laterally. So lateral wall is tympanic membrane from the lateral side. Now in this tympanic membrane we have to show the erocycles, that is malleus and incus. Let me show it, that the malleus we have to draw it in such a way that head of the malleus will be present above. Let me draw it this level, or maybe I can decrease the size of tympanic membrane. I can just decrease the size of tympanic membrane so it will be easier for us. Here we will draw the tympanic membrane at this level. This much size is enough, tympanic membrane, and we draw the malleus. Now this is what we have to draw. This is the malleus. Remember, the head and the anterior process will be lying superiorly, and below this will be the handle of malleus. So this is the head of the malleus and anterior process. Similarly, there will be incus. Now this incus will be present just behind, this incus will be present just behind and it will have long process, short process and body of incus. So therefore this is the body of incus, this will be the short process and this is the long process of incus. Epitympanic part, tympanic part. Now we have to show in the lateral wall this much structure. Since we have made, we will mark these structures here: malleus, incus, and now comes the cauda tympani. Now the most important element, most important structure of the lateral wall, cauda tympani. Now this cauda tympani, now here I will use one color, I will show it with orange color. This cauda tympani now will cross, see here, it will cross this handle of malleus from the medial side and will exit anteriorly. Now, therefore, this cauda tympani now will pass through posterior canaliculi. Let me draw this posterior canaliculi. So here we mention this as posterior canaliculi. This we mention it as cauda tympani now, which is a branch of facial nerve, lateral wall. What is posterior canaliculus? At the junction of lateral and posterior wall, there will be presence of posterior canaliculi. through which caudal tympani now will enter. It is a branch of facial nerve. It will enter the lateral wall of tympanic cavity. As it enters the lateral wall, it will travel medial to the handle of malleus. This relation is very important. Medial to the handle of malleus. And then it will traverse through the lateral wall of tympanic cavity and will exit through anterior canaliculus. What is anterior canaliculus? Now supposing here, I will mention this structure as anterior canaliculus. It is the medialmost part of the pitrotympanic fissure. Medialmost part of the pitrotympanic fissure. And where is this pitrotympanic fissure? At the junction of the anterior and lateral wall of middle ear cavity. So at the junction of lateral and anterior wall, there is pitrotympanic fissure. The most medial part of pitrotympanic fissure will have anterior canaliculus through which the caudal tympani now will exit. Now the second important structure which will exit from this anterior canaliculus, that is from pitrotympanic fissure, will be the anterior ligament of malleus. And that anterior ligament of malleus will be attached to the anterior process of the malleus. It will also exit like this, anterior ligament of malleus. Please draw that. And that anterior ligament of malleus, let me write down this as anterior ligament of malleus, will be attached outside through the anterior canaliculus, that is through pitrotympanic fissure, into spine of sphenoid. So therefore this is the spine of sphenoid on which anterior ligament of malleus will be attached. And the last point will be, this handle of malleus will be attached to the tympanic membrane and it will pull the tympanic membrane inside medially. So therefore it will produce a convexity medially. The convexity is directed towards tympanic cavity, towards the medial side, medially. And that convexity will be known as UMBO, U-M-B-O. These are the points of lateral wall of the middle ear cavity. Here we finished the lateral wall of middle ear cavity.